Like I bring people to do
this. Wait, sir. Hold up. Now you're saying, what are you saying? What did you just finish saying?
You can use this to teach people how to build, to make roof, to make. So because in the process of trying to fix this place on a voluntary basis, you teach people skills. And this is easy to do. You go to a place like the Technical College in Cape Town, Technical College, any place in Stellenbosch, I can arrange this. Because the tools, you don't need any tools. You just need to set the bricks, fix, know how to do the roof, and through that you do it.
Yeah, but after it's done, the reason why I got this way isn't because maintenance. In other words, maintenance is everything. We can do it for them.
No, you're not going to do it for them. You're going to put a notice out for the local community and say, look, public, will you be interested in doing this? It's for free. We're going to teach you how to do this, and we're going to feed you. Subsequently, it is your responsibility to maintain it so that we teach students how to maintain. So that like every once in a week, once in a month, people go around and say, what is wrong here? From here, you start fixing. The commercial part of it is helping to build the community. No, I have these skills. I'm doing this thing for free, but I can build for you, for yours for at a discount. I can build yours at a discount. So we bring skills into the community.
Mm-hmm. Well, now let me ask you. I don't want to be the as I would like to say the angel's advocate. Mm-hmm. But even after you bring these skills, what happens? The people don't stay. If they got a little bit of skills, they run someplace else. How are you going to keep them in the community?
If you because they own property in the community. If they start owning property in the community and they realize that there are skills that are wanted in the community, and the best people to do this is some people in Cape Town, they are the solution about Cape Town and Johannesburg. You get me? You see me and you, you've been all over the world, but you now say, this is where I want to be. Mm-hmm. Those are the kind of people you set. So before you employ somebody, before you bring them on the program, you should test their commitment to it.
Mm-hmm. What does Puma think about all this? Explain this to Puma, what you think should happen.
You know, these two buildings are here lying down. Every tools are there. In trying to build this, nobody will build it, but the community can build this. But if we find two people who are experts in the field and eight other people who are ready to learn, you get what I mean? So in trying to build this thing, people learn how to make roof, how to plaster, how to maintain buildings like this. So that after maintaining this as a showpiece, we show this to the community. We then go from most abandoned buildings here. The guy showed me up a nice building they abandoned. Nobody is doing anything about it. If somebody like you and me go and work on this building, fix the inside, say this is a community hall or something, nobody is going to take it from us.
Of course.
You say, because we do this. Say we've been lying around there for years. And we apply the same thing. We go to a Matole Hotel. We say we are not employing skills. Every Saturday, every Sunday, people come here. We build bricks ourselves. We do it whole, bricks by brick. You get what I'm saying? And it is done. We learn it how to do it. That Amatole Hotel will bring tourists just to see and live there because it's very historic. This school, if this is properly fixed, this is what we fix with our hand. Heritage Agency, the government is forced to put in money because we never ask for anything. We will go to people, we know who to go to, the end user, the builder, what do you call those, builder's warehouse. This is what we want to do. We're not asking you for money, please. We need so much plaster. We need so much paint. We need so much tools. You get what I mean? And we know we have only one plaster, one engineer, and we have nine people we want to teach.
Well, Puma, I hate to put this to you, but you know, you've had this has been here for quite a while. How many years is it?
We.
Yeah, well, this is this situation. Yeah.
Situation. It's about 13 years.
Because 13 years.
Yeah, we've been here 2003.
13 years. Now, think about this. Think about this. I'm just asking a question. Now, surely people have said this before. How come it hasn't happened? Why does it not happen? Why do you think so? You know?
People, they just take time for jealous. I don't know. You know?
What would they be jealous of? The children here are the ones that are thrown away from the other schools.
Well, yeah, they've been thrown away from other schools, and they are here now, you know, and there's no place for them to go. They stuck here. They have to be here, and they have to learn here. And also, we need them to stay, and like a residential kind, you know. Because we've got so many people, children, that need to be here, but they are not here because of the situation, you know, that the building is not conducive for them.
Well, even if you had the building, don't you have to maintain it? Don't you have to have staff? How are you going to pay for all the staff and the maintenance of this stuff? There's a question though, Lou. How is he going to pay for the staff and the maintenance after you get this thing going?
You see, they're paying for the staff and maintenance. Remember, there's two things going on here. In trying to do this, we will have in scale like 5 or 6 people. If you go around this city, there's a lot of similar buildings like this who are in a state of dilapidation. But when we move there, then I move there. The state, the National Heritage Agency, you know, a lot of organizations that are responsible for heritage conservation, you get what I mean? They will pay. You get what I mean? And the process will pay for itself too, because it will be a showpiece. It's not only tied to say we are rebuilding this, we are rebuilding the community, because we go from this to another major monument, to another major building like this school I was telling you, and we start doing that too. Through doing that, we can now write a proper, we can showcase it to the Eastern Cape Province, the national government, and we can go international with it. We don't need money from you, we just need resources and skills to finance it. Then, after some of that, pools. We start building houses, we start showing people, look, you don't need to be sharks. This is the basic thing to build a house. Put the foundation in, put some bricks in, and then you start constructing traditionally. The moment that skills in the community, we can build this. Look at people in Rhodes, in Grahamstown. They actually don't need to go anywhere. Their whole buildings are well maintained. Some people never leave Rhodes and they're making good money. And spread all over this country, they don't need to go to the village, to the city. Only black people rush to the city. Folks are pocket isolated places and developing and living just to create a market. Look at here, for instance, this city you call Alice. There's an annual festival in Grahamstown every year. You get what I mean? We have people, just some people, their only business is preparing for that festival. And they have their income. If Alice has a similar something that people will be forced to come and rent these places, spread around. You understand? Just find an income generating source for the community once in a year. You get what I mean? It takes time.
I hear you.
It takes time. It's not anything super, because here you have one thing, you have a currency. You get what I mean? If you said, I'm selling Alice, please come to me at a festival in Alice. Most people will come. Yes. But you must have taken the first step. For this one, just build this warehouse, take the picture, write the proposal, and say, this is what we can do. Before they come themselves, we have gone into this building, clear the land, clear the ground is set. How many stores we have is here. You get what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
The little we have, we just don't say we leave it till they come. Before they come, we have cleared it. It's everywhere. It's all those brick falling down, all those things up. We have taken the roof forward and moved it to one side, because we will reuse some of them.
Okay, well, I'm going to end it here, but I don't want to end on a down note, but there's a facetious way we say, well, good luck with that.
Thank you.